Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. Now, if you caught the last episode, then you know exactly where we're picking up. If you didn't, you need to go back and watch the last episode, and there will be a link to it. I left off in the last episode explaining just how simple auto is. It just deduces the type of the expression that you're assigning it to. It will never deduce a reference, and it follows the same rules as template type parameters. It's really straightforward. And Bjarne first implemented it in 1984 or something, so it's not like it's a new thing. The fact is, and that's where this episode will pick up, the compiler has always basically had to do the work of auto. Alright, so, you know, I've got this function called getRef. I'm going to go ahead and create another function, stub one out, called getRef2. I'm going to simplify a couple of things here, delete a little bit of code, but still leave us in the same general place. Let's go ahead and do an expression like this. This code would have been valid since the beginning of time, since C++ 98, since before C++ 98, pretty much. Where I have been adding two const references to strings. The compiler has to know that by adding two const references to strings, I am getting back a new string. Now, why did it have to know that? Because it had to know that if I do something like this, that can't compile. It knows that the thing being returned is a string, and I'm trying to assign it to an integer. It can't do that. Can't convert a basic string to an integer. Implicit conversions of various sorts have existed in the standard, again, since the beginning. So, what does it matter from the perspective of the compiler if I say I want a string S here, or if I say I want an auto here? Either way, it had to deduce the return type of this expression, and it had to do something intelligent with it. I ask, what did it matter? But there is definitely a place where it matters. So let's create a function that returns a const character pointer. Call it getString, as one might have done. For those of you who don't like auto, and I know there's a lot of you, and I know that some of you are watching this video, this is what I have to say to you. This code is going to compile without warning. But what did it actually just do? It took this const character pointer and constructed a standard string from it. It did this by calling the implicit conversion operator, the single parameter constructor of standard string that takes a const character pointer. And it is going to have to take that character pointer. It's going to have to call strlen on it. It's going to have to do potentially a heap allocation and then a free and all these things. But let's just say that this was some sort of global data. Just to keep it real, this code is completely valid. I'm returning a pointer to a const character literal that is completely valid. The lifetime of that const character literal is for the lifetime of the program. Auto, which will never deduce a reference and will deduce constness, it'll never perform a conversion. This is the main strength of auto. So in this particular case, the compiler is able to optimize this away from me now because it knows the length of the string. So excuse me while I make it slightly longer. And we'll see whether or not GCC's heap elision comes into play. Okay, it's not, but it is still optimizing it a good deal. So let's just go ahead and make this an auto here. It's not going to create a standard string, so there's no possibility that it's ever going to perform some sort of implicit conversion here because I'm not giving it a type to implicitly convert to. So I see code like this all the time. Let's just say I have a string from somewhere. And I'll see people do something like this, and they don't have their warnings turned up high enough to actually get a warning from the compiler saying that they're doing some sort of conversion here. Now I'm going to get a warning here because I have all my warnings turned on. Conversion from size type to int, blah, blah, blah. So let's just turn off dash w conversion. We're going to get a conversion here from an unsigned 64-bit int to a 32-bit signed int. And if you saw my quick perf tip on avoiding implicit conversions with integers, then this would be familiar to you. Another one that I find particularly interesting is if I've got something that is going to return a map of string to string. So I am iterating over all of the elements in this map. And as you can see, this is a pair of string to string, and I have a map of string to string. I have a const reference here. Let's just take a quick look. This is generating 161 lines of assembly. Now, I'll give you just a moment to look at this. And some of you who have been in my classes or have seen my other conference talks and videos may be aware of what's going on here. But I'm going to go ahead and make one quick change. There we go. So that went from 161 lines of assembly to 6. And all I did was add const here. That is because standard pair has implicit conversions. It can implicitly convert between const and non-const members of the pairs. So in the previous code, in this version, I'm actually making a copy. It looks like a const reference. See, it says const reference, but it is actually a const reference to a temporary that is created by copy through an implicit conversion operator provided by standard pairs constructors of the elements in the map. This is a terrible situation to be in. Now let's go ahead and turn our errors, our warnings back on. If I turn on dash w all in a sufficiently modern GCC, I'm going to get this loop variable lm of type pair, blah, 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 binds to a temporary constructed of this type. And this is my range loop construct. This is a very new warning from our compilers. And if I put the const here, then I should expect that to go away. This is an awful lot of words, though. So mark this as maybe unused so that we can get past this issue. Now, of course, as I was stating before, auto will never ever perform a conversion. This is your best default for for loops. And in many cases, it's just simply your best default because you know that you're never going to conversion. So auto is generally better performing because it eliminates the possibility of an accidental conversion. By telling the compiler to deduce the type for us, it is impossible that it will ever perform an accidental conversion. Although I am waiting for one of you to actually put a comment in the video about how I'm wrong here, but I'm pretty sure I'm not wrong. We might get accidental copies, but that's only by misunderstanding the rules of auto. So if we have here, auto will never deduce a reference type, just remember that. And make sure that you specify a reference when you want a reference. So in all of my examples, you'll see something like this, const auto reference. Now, another bonus side effect of using auto here is it is just a great way for actually iterating over key value pairs from a map, as we can use C++ 17's structured bindings. I still have to mark this as maybe unused because I'm not actually doing anything with it. And we're going to get the same assembly generated again. So there you go. Prefer auto if you want better performing, better, more correct code. We're going to eliminate these possibilities of accidental conversions and accidental copies. It's generally speaking the right choice. Thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. be sure to subscribe.